If you're looking for a capable gaming laptop with decent specifications that can allow you to compete at the highest level on all esports titles while also providing you a good set of features that every content creator is looking for, the 2024 RG 6 G16 is a very viable option at less than 100,000 Philippine pesos. What I have here is the Eclipse Gray variant. To be exact, the model name is G614JU-N4450, just in case you want to cross-reference it with other models. This variant is powered by a 13th-gen Intel Core i7-13650HX processor with an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4050 graphics with 16GB of RAM, 1TB of Gen 4 NVMe SSD, and features a 16-inch WQXGA display that is 2560x1600 resolution and up to 240Hz refresh rate. Fairly decent for any competitive FPS title. Now, like with our last gaming laptop video, which is the ASUS TUF Gaming A16, which by the way, you can watch after this, I'm also going to share with you 5 reasons why I recommend the 2024 RG 6 G16. So without further ado, let's get into it. As always, honest disclaimer, this video is in partnership with ROG to help spread the word about the most affordable variant of the RG 6 G16. So this will not be a full review, but as usual, I still provide you with all the necessary details for you to make a proper purchasing decision. With that out of the way, here are the 5 notable things that I like about the 2024 RG 6 G16, starting with the design and subtle revamp of the chassis. It's so subtle that you might not even recognize it if you're not that familiar with the lineup. But yeah, we have a more minimal ROG slash pattern, still with an ROG eye here, and essentially the same design at the rear end. Upon opening the lid, the new minimal design of the ROG Pixel pattern continues, which makes the overall design language cleaner while still being recognizable as an ROG laptop. Now, while we're here, let's take a look around the rest of the laptop. Looking from above, again, we have the new minimal design pattern with some nice chamfered edges and curved corners, and then at the rear end, we have a sort of subtle two-tone pattern design. And for additional visual interest, we also have some paint specking patterns above the rear exhaust. We also have a small lip at the center that not only helps with opening the lid, but also serves as an extra space to accommodate the webcam and the microphone array. By the way, like most ASUS and ROG laptops, the LED indicators are also visible regardless if the lid is closed or open, which is always appreciated. Flipping it at the bottom, you might get confused by the design implementation here, but all of which are designed to provide enough ventilation for substantial air intake. More on that later. We also have a good amount of rubber feet with taller than usual clearance to keep this thing stay in place. Of course, we also have here the stereo speakers on both sides and the iconic RGB light bar across the front that extends a bit on both sides. Now looking at the front side, as you can tell, for a gaming laptop, this is still relatively thin. As per my measurement, it is just around 28.4mm, including the thick rubber feet and the clearance it provides. On the left side, we have exhaust ventilation, the power port, a 2.5Gb Ethernet port, an HDMI 2.1 port, which is nice to see by the way, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C ports, one of which supports Thunderbolt 4 and the other one supports DisplayPort and power delivery. And lastly, we have a 3.5mm audio combo jack. On the other side, we have another exhaust ventilation and 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports for your external peripherals. Now, as we take a look at the massive exhaust at the back, let's discuss the second reason why I like the ROG 6 G16, which is the ROG Intelligent Cooling. We all know that ROG has been at the forefront of everything when it comes to cooling technology, from their reliable 6 graphics cards to the cooling of their latest OLED gaming monitors, down to pretty much every single product line that requires any type of cooling solution, including probably one of the most, if not the most important product that needs the top-of-the-line cooling, a gaming laptop. Imagine cooling such powerful components inside. Both the chassis and motherboard have been redesigned to accommodate a larger full-width heatsink with fans being closer to the exhaust. Aside from that, what sets this apart from its competitors is the fact that they were able to fit in a third fan specifically for the GPU and VRAM, partnered with 7 heat pipes and conduct-to-not extreme liquid metal on both the CPU and GPU. As I've pointed out earlier, the design of the chassis itself also helps with providing a good amount of airflow coming from the bottom with a substantial amount of gap as you can see here. As long as you place the laptop on a solid and even surface, you'll get the best airflow possible. Now, even though this is not a full review, I took the liberty to actually test that cooling system. In 1 hour of stress test using the 3D Mark Steel Nomad benchmark, which by the way is the latest non-ray traced cross-platform GPU benchmark from UL Solutions and is 3 times heavier than TimeSpy and 7 times heavier than Firestrike, which makes it a viable option to test a machine's cooling solution, the ROG Strix G16 performed pretty well, maxing out below 90 degrees on both turbo and performance mode for both the CPU and GPU with pretty decent averages around the 60s. It also passed the stability test using either the turbo or performance modes. So yeah, cooling is something you need not worry about this gaming laptop. Now, the third thing that I like about the ROG Strix G16 is something very important to me as a content creator and as a competitive gamer, which is the ROG Nebula display. The variant that I have here features a 16-inch 2560x1600 Quad HD Nebula display with up to 240Hz refresh rate, 3 milliseconds response time, and up to 500 nits of brightness. Of course, with G-Sync support. That is good enough for any competitive FPS game. As you can tell, it also features super slim bezels all around. Even the bottom bezel is also fairly slim. Now, as per my testing, using the SpiderX color calibration tool, the display looks decently calibrated out of the box with Pantone color validation and can output at least up to 100% sRGB, 85% NTSC, 87% Adobe RGB, and 99% DCI P3, which is right around its 100% P3 specifications. This means this is good enough even for content creation and professional social media and web applications. As per testing, also using the SpiderX color calibration tool, it also has a peak brightness of around 495.6 nits, which is also around its 500 nits specifications, more than enough for indoor use and good enough for its Dolby Vision support. As you can tell, the display's image quality is really outstanding. The colors are super vibrant, with decent contrast in details, and a substantial amount of brightness. Like I said, the brightness is more than enough for indoor use, which is nice to see for HDR content. This is definitely one of the strong points of this gaming laptop. Viewing angles are also pretty decent, especially on realistic use case scenarios. But even with this kind of extreme viewing angle, it's still pretty much watchable. I'm pretty sure anyone would be impressed by the image quality of this display. For competitive gaming, the 240Hz, 3 milliseconds response time of this display is good enough and might be even better than most at this price range. Partnered with the capable hardware inside, which will be discussed in just a bit, playing competitive esports title on this is super viable and I can confidently play competitive matches using this. I just need to slap in an external keyboard and mouse and I'm pretty much good to go. The integrated keyboard is decent, but you'll get more freedom with an external keyboard. I just want to point that out. Speaking of capable hardware inside, that is the fourth thing that I like about the ROG Strix G16. A good set of complementing hardware specifications to reliably compete at the highest level while also being able to get creative with productivity and content creation. Like I mentioned in the intro, this variant of the 2024 ROG Strix G16 is powered by a 13th gen Intel Core i7 13650HX processor with an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4050 graphics with 16GB of RAM and 1TB of Gen 4 NVMe SSD. While it's not the latest and greatest, for a relatively affordable price of around less than 100,000 Philippine pesos, that is good enough for what it has to offer. What sets it apart though is that it supports up to 140 watts TGP for the graphics with MUX switch and NVIDIA Advanced Optimus to take advantage of it directly without having to go through the integrated graphics. For gaming, I was able to get around 300 plus FPS in Valorant in high settings, which is more than what the 240Hz refresh rate display can offer and good enough for a decent competitive gaming experience. I didn't feel like it was holding me back even at the 1600p resolution. It felt smooth and responsive. The only thing I'm missing here is the larger display size I have on my main desktop monitor. In Counter-Strike 2 in very high settings, also in 1600p resolution, I was able to get around 100 plus FPS, which is still pretty decent. In another esports title, Rainbow Six Siege, I was able to get around 150 plus FPS. I don't play this game, so I can only show you some clips of the built-in benchmark. Now, in a more graphics-intensive game like the Cyberpunk 2077, at ultra settings with DLSS quality and frame generation turned on, I was able to squeeze in at least around 60 FPS, which is nice to see considering we're playing at 1600p resolution. And as you can tell, the thermals are well below the 90 degrees range. And lastly, since I recently got hooked on Diablo 4, I also played quite a few hours using the ROG Strix G16 and I was able to get around 90 plus FPS at the maximum settings available, still at 1600p resolution. And man, this is where I also appreciated the outstanding image quality of the display. The skill animations pop really vibrant and give that immersive gaming experience. Lastly, in terms of performance, just to give you a more tangible and easy to replicate data, here are all the 3DMark benchmark results that I got for the ROG Strix G16. And for productivity, here are a couple of benchmarks that I ran using the recently launched ProSion benchmark, also from UL Solutions. Now, the fifth reason why I recommend the ROG 6D16 is something every consumer needs to consider when purchasing a gaming laptop or any product for that matter, which is warranty and support. The ROG 6G16 is part of the ASUS 4A quality and service program, providing consumers with up to 2 years international warranty with one-time preventive maintenance, one-time accidental damage protection for 1 year, plus ASUS Premium Care upgrade package options. 4A means assured quality, all-around coverage, added value experience, and always-on support. I'll put some links below for a detailed overview of what the ASUS 4A quality and service has to offer. Now, before we finish this video, we also have a decently sized trackpad here, which is quite responsive with good tactile buttons and a decently sized keyboard as well, albeit without a numpad. But with dedicated arrow keys, full function rows up top, a few customizable shortcut buttons, and a dedicated power button. It also has customizable RGB lighting with some translucent accent keys and of course, like I mentioned earlier, a complementing RGB edge lighting around the front side. Overall, for the price of just under 100,000 Philippine pesos, this variant of the 2024 ROG 6G16 strikes a good balance when it comes to features and performance without necessarily having to break the bank. This is good for competitive gamers and content creators on the go, as well as digital artists, young professionals, and pretty much everyone who needs a capable device but doesn't require a top-of-the-line level of features and performance. Especially if you're only going to play competitive esports titles, you don't have to spend a ton of money for a higher-tier processor and graphics power while still getting a pretty decent display and essentially all the features an ROG 6 laptop has to offer. And there you have it guys, thank you for watching. Huge thanks to ROG for letting me experience the 2024 ROG 6 G16 and for partnering with me on this video. I also want to share with you that this is also part of ASUS and ROG's ongoing Cool for School campaign, which allows you to get up to 11,500 Philippine pesos worth of bundled items. And for this exact variant, you can also get an additional 1 year of warranty extension for a total of 3 years. By the way, inside the box, you'll also get a super nice ROG backpack and an ROG 6 Impact gaming mouse, plus 3 months of Xbox Game Pass Ultimate and 1 month trial for new Microsoft 365 customers. I'll put some links below if you're interested. Now, if you're looking for one of the best gaming monitors out in the market, make sure to watch my review of the ROG 6 OLED XG27AQ DMG gaming monitor by clicking this. Thank you for watching, subscribe if you appreciate this video, and see you on the next one. Have a great day guys, you're awesome!